You draw me close to your embrace, arms open wide, hands filled with grace. I know you're here with me. I know you're here with me. When I am weak, you are made strong. When I give up and can't go on, I know you're here with me. I know you're here with me. Nothing
else can satisfy. I hate you.
What?
You're as skinny as the day we met.
Ah, come on. Well, you're as... I mean,
I'm as what?
Who am I fooling? You're huge. I mean, you're monstrous.
Thanks. That's the pep talk I needed before your parents get here.
Hey,
you subtract that baby weight, you're thin as a rail.
I can do the math. You take off 7 or 8 pounds for the baby, I'm still a porker.
But you're a pretty porker.
What am I looking for?
Something snooty enough to please your snobby mother. And big enough to cover a pretty porker.
You should just wear your robe. Oh, it's comfy.
I'm always disappointing your mother.
Hey, that's why I married you.
And I guess I'm wearing the robe.
Okay. You know what? Wait a sec.
Wear that smelly, nasty thing just to take the heat off me.
I'd do anything for you.
That's why I married you. Ew.
Yeah, that's gross.
Go. Where?
Out.
All right. Doing it again.
Doing what?
Pushing me out. Pushing all your friends out.
No. Her friends. Angel couldn't leave the house without making a new friend.
I know.
You're the only friend I got.
Then why are you drifting away, Chase?
I don't know. Maybe I just need more time.
Well, you need to see her friends, too.
That's hard. Look, I know that's the way to keep her memories alive, seeing her friends. I get that. But I want her alive. Thanks.
Hey, it's good to see you, Chase.
Yeah. Rick dragged me out.
Kicking and screaming.
I'm sorry to hear what happened.
Thank you.
A woman are supposed to have an intuition. Try to make it back off.
Don't worry about it. It's okay.
What?
I can't remember her name.
So? What's funny about that?
Angel knew. She knew everything about her.
Remember how hard it was getting her out of a party?
Yeah, I thought we made a clean break at your last birthday.
Yep, you had 1 foot out the door.
I did have 1 foot out the door. And then I heard her ask that woman that one simple question.
Yeah, what was that?
What do you mean a sticky divorce? We were always the guests. You would never leave.
Yeah, you guys never did. You guys are always the last ones out.
What?
Something I gotta say, Chase.
Go ahead.
I made a promise to Angel.
What?
Well, even before she...
Oh my God, Rick. I think at this point you could say it.
Well, even before she died, I promised I'd see you through this.
You don't have to. I'm okay.
I do have to, Chase. You're not okay, buddy.
So there's no getting rid of you.
Right. And you're making new friends.
Rick, I'm not any good at that.
I figure one friend a week.
Look, Rick, I know smoozing suits at business meetings, okay? And I'm good at that. I've always been good at that, but that's different. That's business, all right? I don't have time to make friends. I don't have time for that right now. What about the business?
What about the business? You know our motto.
Yeah, I know. Buying the bubble and selling the burst.
We can let it burst more.
Listen, I heard Evergreen Properties is going into Chapter 11 right now. Look, we could buy up malls. We could buy up power centers. All of that on the cheap.
Look, I'll take care of that. You got homework to do.
Yeah, I get it. Make friends.
Yeah, I figure one a week.
All right. Okay.
I got a list. I got fundraisers, places to go.
Look, I'm not making friends that way, okay? If we're going to make friends, I'm going to do it my way. That means negotiations, research, lots and lots of research.
You need that to make a friend?
I'm going to be damn sure before I got to help somebody move or have to give them a ride to the airport. We done here, Rick?
Procedures, names, addresses.
Histories.
Yeah, everything. So are we cool or what?
Yeah. Yeah, we're cool.
Chase? Chase Fannon?
Dr. Gray.
Same room?
Yeah.
What brings you here?
I'm not sure. I guess I just wanted to remember.
And there's a lot better place to remember your wife than here.
I guess.
Have you thought about seeing a therapist or grief counseling?
I'm fine.
Well, think about it. I'll get you that referral. You remember him?
Who could forget him? That's the poor man that got the 2-for-1. He lost his wife and the baby.
What was his friend's name?
Rick something. Would you like me to check the visitor's log?
Yeah. Better do it now.
Yeah.
Give her 10 more grams. Chase, I'm sorry. We've done all we could. Her heart's strong, but she has no brain activity.
Can I say goodbye?
Of course you can. You take all the time you need.
Cuando pienso en tu gran amor, en los momentos que me siento solo, ¿quién soy yo? ¿Quién soy yo que te acuerdas de mí? Mis ojos han visto tu amor. Mis oídos escuchan.
Oh, we're talking.
Listen, you're great. You're great.
Oh. Hey, Chase.
Hi, Terry.
I'm so glad you could make it.
Well, no, me never turned down a free meal. Phil.
Phil's kind of having issues with Nancy right now, so there's an empty spot too, because Rick is out of town.
So in other words, Rick wanted you to babysit me.
No, that's not it at all.
Look, tell Rick I'm fine, okay? He worries way too much. Look, Phil, I hate to bother you guys with this right now, but Phil, I got a legal question, okay? This man, the drunk driver that hit Angel, he's got something tomorrow called a preliminary hearing. What is that about?
That means the state puts on a little evidence to show they have a case. The defense attorney can challenge it.
Should I be worried about that?
No, he was way over the legal limit. No way he'll walk.
All right. That's good. It's kind of a load off my mind.
Are you going tomorrow?
Yeah. Yeah, I am.
What time tomorrow?
I think it's at 9.
It's kind of early.
Yeah, but I gotta get a look at this guy's face.
I have a motion in another department, but I'll get there as soon as I can.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Hey, why don't you get a chance of beer?
Taryn, guys, sure? Don't worry about it. I'll get it. Hold on.
I brought the good stuff.
Thanks, Phil.
Transplant teams and tell them I'm on my way.
Which teams?
Heart and eyes, and the kidneys are on the way.
Okay.
Chase? Chase? Hey, you want me to grab you a beer?
No. No, actually, I brought wine, okay. And I left it in the car. I'll be back in a jiff.
I went through a really sticky divorce.
I went through a divorce too.
What do you mean a sticky divorce?
That's Tommy Thompson. He's the best in town.
Yeah, I've seen his cheesy commercials.
He knows his way around a courtroom.
Oh yeah, right. If it's a DUI, I'm your guy.
Judge, paperwork I handed you is an emergency motion to dismiss.
Judge, I just got this yesterday.
Sit down. I'll hear the motion.
Attested motion is a letter from Deputy District Attorney, saying that they cannot and will not be able to produce the nurse who did the blood draw for the blood alcohol test.
Your Honor, the nurse completed an affidavit.
The affidavit statute only allows for specific details. What they submitted contains several discrepancies and far exceeds at the level of the statute.
Why don't you have the nurse come in and clear this up?
Your Honor, she died in a car accident last week.
In light of these circumstances, it's critical for my client to exercise his Sixth Amendment right for confrontation at trial.
That's not possible. The witness is dead.
Then the affidavit should have come into evidence.
This is bad. Real bad.
All right. The affidavit is out.
This thing has no evidence that my client was under the influence, so I moved to immediately dismiss all charges.
Is there anything else? Field sobriety test? Officer's reports? Motion to dismiss is granted. Mr. Morris, you're free to go. But if I see you in my courtroom another time, I'll go out of my way to make sure it's hard on you. Quiet in the courtroom!
now, man. She didn't care about stuff like that. It's just the way she was.
My first old lady was like that, man. Before I lost her.
So how'd you get over it?
You don't ever get over it. You just learn to get by.
Chase Fannon?
Can satisfy, 'cause your love just won't run dry. There's no place I'd rather be than with you. My soul is free.
Record, he wished the bailiff got there a little later.
Well, is he going to drop the contempt charges?
Yes, but Chase has to agree to grief counseling.
I don't need it. I'm fine.
The hell you don't, Chase. You haven't lived a day in their presence since Angel.
That's intentional. I don't want to forget. I'm not going to forget.
You were banging a guy's head in open court, Chase. You need help.
You need help.
All right, guys, listen. All a grief counselor's gonna do is help me move on. Forget about her. That's not helping me.
Don't do it for yourself, Chase. Do it for Angel.
All right. All right, I'll do it.
Well, then what about Morris?
Tommy Thompson's usually a bona fide jerk, but he's been helping us get the assault case settled.
Well, that's good.
Well, there's strings attached.
I'm not bargaining with that guy.
You have to. He could take you to the cleaners on a civil assault claim.
All right, what's he want?
He wants $10,000 and you don't make a claim on his auto insurance.
All right, fine.
And he wants you to apologize to him.
For that, I'm sorry.
I took your bitch out. And I made you my bitch.
Shut the hell up!
Chase, I know you're not going to forgive me, but I want you to know that I am truly sorry. This is one case I wish I never would have won.
Can I get you?
I'll take a coffee black.
Be right back.
So why'd you need to see me, Phil?
I can't let you see it. And it's a breach of confidence for me to even discuss it.
But what is it?
The report from the grief counselor. I'm about to submit it to the judge so Chase's contempt charge is wiped clean.
What does it say, Phil?
After working through the five grief stages, Chase Fannon has shown remarkable progress over the last 6 months in dealing with the untimely passing of his wife, Angel, and his unborn son.
Well, that's great. That's a conclusion. How about some details?
The counselor talks about three new friends Chase has made. He spends a lot of time with them, going places and doing things.
That's why he's always busy when I invite him out.
Look, I wish we saw more of him too, but this is a good thing.
You're right. It's a good thing.
So now you have confirmation.
Confirmation of what?
You told me he appeared to be doing well at the office.
Yeah, well, accent on the word appeared.
Now, there's an expert saying he's fine, so you can stop worrying.
I want to meet his new friends.
Maybe you should leave it alone. He has a new life, new friends.
New trouble.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
To use those trite cliches in court?
So I can be still. Please don't let me go. Hold me in your love. Give me a clean heart. Oh God up above, renew me, transform me. Oh God, your love is sufficient for me. Renew me, transform me, oh God. Your love is sufficient for me. So take me, mold me into your image, into your image.
All right, the hippie chick.
And?
Went back to her van.
She went to go get vegan dishes.
Ugh, gross. So what about the old codger?
I think they prefer coot as an old coot.
His name is Hank.
Well, you two girls work on the girl, and me and this guy will pump the old geezer for info.
This is supposed to be a party, you know, for your best friend Chase. He's your business partner.
This is for Chase. Mm-hmm. But you can't say that you never probed anybody for info before.
Okay.
Out of sheer nosiness.
Mm. Hey!
Hey!
What'd you bring?
That's about a tray in lime rice and beans, and that's Moroccan chickpeas with couscous.
You really didn't have to set yourself up like that.
I don't mind. I love to cook.
That's good. Has Chase ever eaten vegan with you?
No, not really. We alternate restaurants, so only one of us has to fill up in the salad bar.
Okay.
Are you two romantically involved?
Nancy.
It's alright. We're friends. Good friends.
How'd you guys meet?
Chase bought the house that I'm running.
Mm-hmm.
Is he your landlord?
Yeah, we got to know each other, and then we became partners.
Partners, huh?
Business partners. Chase encouraged me to sell my stained glass creations over the internet.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah, I hated my job. Mm. Chase encouraged me to start my own business.
You know, my husband Rick, he's business partners with Chase.
I know. I can't believe a man that makes multi-million dollar deals would take the time to mentor me.
Chase is pretty special.
He is. He really is special.
you saw a ghost, boy.
No, Hank. I just didn't expect to see you here.
You look familiar, Vic. Have we met?
No, I don't think so. Pretty good faces, I think I remember.
What line of work are you in?
Investing, imports, exports, a little of this, a little of that. What do you do?
I'm a criminal defense lawyer.
Yeah, well, most of Phil's acquaintances, they are felons.
Whoa, cholesterol, Hank.
Jeez, Chase, can't you let me off my leash for one day?
All right, but you know our motto.
Moderation for preservation.
There you go. Hey, I like that. Who said it?
Who do you think?
Hey, do you want some wine?
No, thanks. Just water for me.
How about you, Hank? Do you want some?
Sorry. Boss says no.
More for me.
He's gonna beat me 20 times in a row.
How the hell did you get so good, Hank?
Well, I had to give up smoking, drinking, and good food. I had to have some vice.
Notice I didn't give up wild women.
Hey, some things are worth dying for. Well, it's your move. You need to practice more.
'82 Chateau Lafleur. It's not bad.
Yeah, I'm a noob. It's the best I got.
It's nothing to be ashamed of. It's a good bottle of wine.
Do you collect?
No, I drink it as I buy it. Last thing I bought was a 1985 Latoche.
1985 Latoche?
Yeah.
It's expensive, man.
It's not cheap, no. Is that an 82 Chateau Aubryon over there?
You got good eyesight, my friend.
Didn't always, but yeah.
Do you invest in commercial real estate at all?
Yeah, all the time, actually.
Has Chase ever told you exactly what we do?
No. Usually we try and not mix business and pleasure.
Pleasure? What do you guys do for pleasure?
We play bridge. He's my bridge partner. What do you do? What are you working on?
Well, right now, I'm trying to get this investment from the banks for Evergreen Properties. Have you heard of them?
I know them. How much?
It's 2-3 mil, but we're trying to get... We could probably do it for less.
Not pocket change, but might be doable.
You got that much capital.
No, but I do know some people.
And after the Peace Corps, I traveled across Europe before I finished college.
You've had a really interesting life.
I feel like all we're talking about is me.
Oh, that's all right. Terry and I see enough of each other.
Yeah.
It's nice to get some new blood.
Did you know his wife, Angel?
Yeah, she was my best friend.
What was she like?
Angel, she was smart, funny, beautiful.
Not like you.
Not to make it weird or anything, but, does Chase ever talk about Angel?
No, never. Changes the subject if I ask.
He went through hell to get over her.
I don't think he's over.
He seems to be getting by, don't you think?
Seems to be.
You're in love with Chase.
That's so rude.
Well? She's more intuitive than rude.
So you are.
I am. You have to promise not to tell. We can never be more than friends.
Why? Do you think he's too damaged?
It's not Chase, it's me. I just decided never to get married.
I'll be the first to tell you. Marriage has its ups and downs, but it's...
Never say never.
You're too young to swear off marriage.
It wouldn't be fair.
To Chase?
To anyone.
I don't understand.
I have a medical condition.
What is it?
I'd rather not say.
Okay.
I have a few years. 10. Maybe more.
And you don't think it'd be fair to put a man through that?
I don't think it'd be fair to put Chase through that.
I saw firsthand how Chase was with Angel those first few years, and it changed him. It definitely made him a better man.
Hey, time for cake presents.
Okay, hon.
So you think I should go for it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Hank, you should take something.
Oh, thanks. Gotta watch the girlish figure, you know.
How about some chicken breast and salad?
Now you're talking, girl.
Hey, Terry. Seriously, thanks for the birthday party.
Oh, no problem.
Really. And you, mister, thanks for taking time to interrogate my new friends.
Just looking out for you, buddy boy.
I bet you are.
Vic and Ann are good people. But me, I'm rotten to the core.
I love a dangerous man.
You woman always do fall before the bad boys.
Oh, yeah.
God, let's get out of here.
That'd be me. What do you guys think?
I like that old coot.
You see how Chase is watching over him like a hawk?
Like any friend would do.
Well, then what about Vic? He looks like he could be in the mob.
So would you if you wore a decent suit?
I know him from somewhere.
Well, if he is a crime boss, maybe you defended one of his underlings.
Who's his underlings nowadays?
When you have to have a ling to have underlings.
Can we just get serious? I mean, I'm trying to help Chase, and you guys just think it's a joke.
Relax. Chase is fine.
Just something about his friends seems strange.
Like what?
I don't know. It's just a feeling.
Hold on. Let me get into character. Dude, you sound like a woman.
Dude, what about all the pills his friends are popping?
Oh my gosh, that's paranoid. I mean, there are plenty of people on medication.
Oh, okay. They're all wonderful.
Yeah.
You wanna come out tonight?
I wish I could, but I think Rick schedules some sort of business dinner tonight.
Business? On Valentine's Day.
I don't know, he made it sound like it was pretty important.
You need to be with a pretty lady on Valentine's Day, buddy.
Yeah.
You could come to D'Angelo's. I got my table.
Oh, fellas, I wish I could. I love that place.
And he knows his women, too.
And there are some hot ladies there.
I think Hank's had a busy day. He should rest up.
You two boneheads aren't my divorced parents. And I ain't no little kid, you know.
You don't need to be eating all that rich food. Listen, guys, take care. Be careful, all right?
Chase, if you can, though, you should come out.
All right, I'll think about it.
All right, I'll see you. Have fun at your dinner.
And find yourself a woman on Valentine's, will you? Thank you.
Chase. He should have answered it. Oh no, we don't want him expecting anything. Hey, put that on speakerphone so we can listen. What? You know you want to listen.
Okay. Hey, it's me. Look, I know we had plans to work on the website tonight and in the books, but I have a business meeting that came up. I know it's Valentine's Day and all, and anyway, you probably got stuff going on. I'm sorry for canceling.
Aw, that is sweet.
He is so into you.
You really think so?
I could tell it's he was me. Like, it's me.
Oh yeah, you have to know somebody. It's me.
So, why did we get a 6-seater table and we only got 4 people?
We might have company.
Who?
It's a surprise.
I don't think I like the sound of that. Hey, I got you something, babe.
Oh, Rick, it's beautiful.
So are you.
Gosh, thought this was a business dinner.
Nope, just taking the wives out.
That's pretty odd.
No, it's not, Chase. I called your secretary and said it was a meeting.
Look, no offense, guys, but I kind of had plans.
Sit down, please. Please, it's a surprise.
All right.
Good evening, ma'am, sir. Would you like to have a seat in the rear?
Can we have this table, please?
I'm sorry, ma'am. That seat is reserved.
I'd really like to have this table.
You don't understand, ma'am. That seat is reserved.
Can we please have this table?
Give me the opportunity to speak with my manager, please.
Thank you.
So, why this table?
Think about it, Chase.
It's our table. It's where we always sit.
Think harder.
It's where I proposed to you.
That's the right answer for Valentine's Day.
Our manager gave me permission to give you the seat.
Thank you.
Thank you. You know what? I'm gonna be back in a minute. Just wait.
What? It's your fault. This is a chase for closing.
Don't cry. Aw. Here, take this. I'm gonna go get you some napkins, okay? I'll be right back.
The other women had corsages. I felt bad.
How'd you find one so quick?
Well, don't ask and don't tell.
Come on, Chase. You can tell me anything.
All right. I found a couple and standing in line at the Japanese restaurant across the street.
And they just gave it to you?
No.
Tell me the truth, Chase. How much did you pay for it?
For you? $1,000.
That is so capitalistic, so cynical, incredibly romantic.
Well, those are my qualities. Hey, do you want to dance?
I'd love to.
Thank you.
tonight. Good evening, Mr. Mickey. Usual table?
Yes, thank you.
Nick. Is that your brother over there?
Fratello.
We'll take care of it.
I told you I was going to take care of this personally.
You better take care of it, otherwise we will.
Okay, let's get down to business.
Hey, don't make me slap you.
Jesus. You're a bigger nag than Chase.
How long have you known Chase?
I don't know. 8 months, 7, 8 months maybe?
Me too. Don't you think it was strange that he didn't want you to come out tonight?
Not really. Hell, I've had women chase me. Why not men?
You know the medication you take? What's that for?
Medication? Anti-rejection.
For what?
Kidney transplant.
When?
8 months ago?
No, exact date. Exact date when.
Jeez, oh man. What is this, Sherlock Holmes here? What? I don't know. June 13th, I guess. What's so funny?
We've been played.
What's riding around that brain of yours?
On the exact same date, I got my corneas transplanted.
Oh. That is a coincidence.
And you remember that girl from dinner, Anne? I'm willing to bet that she also is a transplant.
We have been played. Chase, that little devil.
And I'm guessing it's probably from the same donor.
Then I guess you won't mind picking up the tab.
No, it's fine.
What do you think his angle was, though?
He loves someone so much that he finds three random strangers just to stay close.
Then who was it?
Well, that's easy. His wife just died.
That's messed up.
It's totally crazy, yeah?
I still like the kid. Even if he is crazier than a bed bug.
I think that I like him even more.
Hey, body buddies?
Organ mates. It sounds a tiny bit more manly. Mm. We can work on it.
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
Vic, surprised to see me.
Huh? Didn't expect to see you here.
I had to fly and take care of some business. Why don't you come and join? I'm going to introduce you to some new friends back there.
Hey, Nikki. Give me a minute. Okay.
Sure. Sure, little brother.
Nick, you should go, okay? Go outside, get a cab, go to the airport, get another cab, and go straight home, okay?
You sure you don't need my help?
No, I don't need your help. I'm fine, I promise.
Hey, I used to box in the Navy.
You can just go, okay?
Don't count me out. I'm a tough old bird.
I know you are, Hank. Now go. I'm fine.
All right.
So, this is what you two cannavers been up to.
Game, set, match.
You don't think it's a bit too soon?
Mm. It's never too soon for love.
Great. You got your answer on a Valentine's Day card.
At least you got a card.
Look, all I'm saying is he's been a basket case for 8 months.
So, he took a few classes.
Well, don't you think that's just a bit odd?
Why don't we just go home and watch some movies? Leave him alone.
Vic? So how's your vision?
It's a lot better now.
Need you to come home.
No. I like it here.
Got a lot of business loose ends you gotta tie up.
I tied up on loose ends before I left.
Fat Tony.
Fat Tony? Tony's too stupid for an angle. What do you want from me?
We can talk. I want you to come back home. You're too young to retire.
No. I'm out.
I want you to come back home.
Hey, did you even see them leave?
They waved goodbye.
We danced for over an hour.
I know.
You're a great dancer.
You're not too shabby yourself.
Did you get this?
No, it's the lover's cake. It comes with the Valentine's meal.
It's good. It's really good. It's actually a great combination.
What's that?
Cake.
Is that what this is?
All of me. Why not take all of me? Can't you see? I'm no good without you. Take my lips. I want to lose them. Take my arms. I'll never use.
Do you love all of me?
Yes.
My swollen feet and ankles?
Yeah. Your big clown feet and your pregnancy-induced cankles.
Oh, my big fat tummy.
Especially that.
My puffy face and ratty hair.
I love your moon pie face and your ragamop too.
Why?
You took the part that once was my heart. So why not take all of me?
Because I love all of you.
All of me?
I love every particle, speck, fiber, drip, dribble. Every molecule.
Even when I'm this big.
There's just more to love.
And I love all of you, too. Chase.
Sorry. Yeah. I think it is. I think we could be.
Folgers can. You're right. You got perfect vision, little brother.
Told you, Nikki. See things more clearly now.
How do you see this ending?
See you ending up like Papa?
This ain't about me. It's about you.
Maybe I see myself at 90 years old playing bocce ball on an island somewhere.
I could see you being a playboy at 90 years old. If you make it.
If?
Vic, there's always an if.
What the f-
Yeah.
Holy shit, Hank. You wrecked my Porsche.
What?
I saved your life, Vic. True. We're even then, okay?
Okay, even then.
Yeah. Is a mob pit insured? I don't know. I'm driving, bro.
Prove myself. Why are you cutting me out of the action?
I already told you. I need you to alibi up.
No, you need me to watch your back.
Hank, I'm fine. Go.
So, why here?
I need to talk to you, Chase.
I've been here before.
Me too.
I wasn't in a good place at that time.
Me either.
So what do you want to talk about?
I think I'm falling in love with you. And I can't fall in love with you.
Why?
My heart.
You don't feel it in your heart?
I do feel it in my heart.
So what's your problem?
My heart came from someone else, a transplant.
I don't care, okay? I don't care. If that heart loves me, then what's the difference?
Time, Chase. Time.
How much time?
A few years. 10, maybe more.
I'd rather spend a few years with you than a lifetime with anybody else.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sure. Hey. You okay?
I'm okay.
Hey, do you need to call an ambulance?
Take me to town.
Yeah, okay.
Drive me to town.
All right.
Bartender. Get another one.
Sorry, Albie, but I'm not allowing you to get a DUI.
Another drink.
No. Go ahead. I'm a designated driver.
Do I know you?
Just say we ran into each other once.
Thank you.
Walker, homicide.
I'm Chase. Is there a problem, Detective Walker?
I'm his lawyer. We'll waive the Miranda warning. What's this about?
Routine investigation at this point.
Chase is a homicide suspect?
Not yet, but he has the greatest motive.
Who was the victim?
Albert Morris.
Yeah. Shut up. You're not helping, Chase.
Give us a half hour to process him in, and we'll try to sort this out.
Okay.
I'm going with you.
We'll be there all night.
Number three, step forward.
No.
Are you sure?
Come on now, detective.
I told you, it was late and dark. I don't remember much about him.
Get out.
No positive ID, so let him go.
He fits the general description.
That doesn't mean squat.
One of them drunks in a bar said he saw a good-looking man in a suit.
That could be anybody. Maybe it was me.
You're not good-looking.
I'll ignore that for now. Why don't you have the drunk here for the lineup?
He's still drunk.
This is ridiculous.
We checked the bartender's drawer. It was like he made a $1,000 tip.
That's not enough to hold my client.
It's enough to make a sleazy bartender forget.
That's it. I'm filing my habeas writ.
Let me ask him a few questions and check out his alibi.
Victorino?
Yeah.
Agent Robert Gillum, FBI.
Thanks for meeting me on such short notice.
No problem.
This is gonna help, Chase.
What's this about?
Well, you know as much as I do.
Chase is in a holding room waiting for his interview. The police are investigating Chase for the murder of Albert Morris.
That's the drunk driver that killed his wife and got off scot-free.
They need to speak to you, Ann.
Why?
You're his alibi witness. I represent Chase, so I can't advise you.
I'm not involved. Chase isn't involved.
Are you sure?
We were together all last night.
Then this could be over real soon.
All night. What happened? Tell us. I told him and he didn't care. He didn't? That's great. That's wonderful.
I can't believe you.
What's your problem?
My best friend, who no one believes is still psychotically depressed over his wife, is now being charged with first-degree murder.
He didn't. He wouldn't. He was with me all last night.
Oh yeah? How would you know? How do you know that Vic wasn't a hitman? How do you know he didn't hire a hitman? You don't know?
What the hell is that?
You don't know anything about Chase.
Don't think you're out of the woods. You and I are gonna have a talk tonight.
Ann Astor, can you come with me?
This is it, isn't it?
I might show up sometime.
I'm a lousy bridge player.
You're terrible, actually. I'm guessing you learned just to meet me.
Yeah.
Listen, Chase. There's something I have to tell you. When I got your wife's eyes,
I told myself that I would, you know, change, that I'd be better. I didn't. Then I met you.
Oh, Vic.
I know.
You didn't have to kill him for me.
I didn't kill him for you. I killed him for Angel.
That's not gonna haunt you.
I have worse things to live down. This was right. I have to go.
Okay. So we'd have something in common.
Did you use me?
Yes, at first, but then I fell in love.
Get out of my life.
Anne, I'm so sorry. First time, I'm living in the present.
You still dream about Angel?
No.
Who do you dream about?
Dan.
Go get her.
I lost her.
Go get her.
Hank, you okay?
Yeah, I just need a little shut-eye, buddy.
All right. Okay. Look, I'll go to the cafeteria and get something.
One thing, bud.
Yeah.
Save me a little fettuccine, huh?
Yeah, sure, buddy.
Don't be afraid, hon. Come in.
Tell Chase you were sleeping.
No. I got tired of him. You heard us talking. You came here to see him?
No, I came here to give him a piece of my mind. What's funny?
Nothing.
Tell me, Hank.
It's what you said. A piece of your mind. It's all about the pieces, isn't it?
I don't understand, Hank.
You, me, Vic. We all got a piece of Angel.
That's why he stalked us, conned us, convinced us that he loved us.
I think Chase is the best friend I've ever had. What does it matter how
Maybe not. But what he did was wrong.
What he did was sad. Crazy. But incredibly romantic.
It was incredibly romantic.
That shows just how much love he's capable of.
But how will I know if he loves me or the piece of her inside of me?
One of Dr. Redner's transplant patients?
Yes. Someone asked her?
Well, you and Hank have the same donor.
Yes.
Well, I guess you know Chase Fannon.
We're all acquainted.
Well, I think it's great you got in touch. It's done real wonders for Chase.
You think so?
Yeah, absolutely. Months after the accident, I caught him staring at the room where his wife died. I was worried then, but now.
What, doctor?
Well, now he won't even look at the room when he passes it. Goodbye.
That's not vegan.
I'm sure this is real meat. So are you still mad at me?
No, I'm just trying to understand you.
Look, what I did was sad. It's crazy. And
incredibly romantic.
I never meant to hurt you. Can you ever forgive me?
I already have. Come on. The forgiving isn't over yet.
What do you mean?
What do you see, Chase?
Empty room.
That's Angel's heart beating inside of me.
I know.
Feel her heart. Look in that room. Tell her what you need to say.
I'm sorry, Angel. I'm so sorry.
Come on, Chase.
It's my fault. It's your alone. You remind me about Lamascus, but I went to a meeting. If I'd been there, you'd still be alive. Goodbye, Angel. Goodbye. You think I'm ever going to get over her?
You're not supposed to get over her, Chase. I'm not supposed to get over Angel. She gave you love. She gave me life.
So what's next?
You love her. You remember her. You move on.
The angels will sing that you are the Lord who is worthy.
Hey, buddy. Look at that. Look at you.
Okay, little man, where do you want to head off to?
Huh? That blasted baby hugger. Give me that little fella.
Oh my god, she's a kicker.
I know.
Hey, Rick, I think we're going to be coming over to your house pretty soon.
Sure. For?
Well, we are renting a giant moving van.
You guys moving in?
No. We're just unloading some of the baby stuff that Tracy's outgrown.
I don't know about that.
You can even need it.
Hey, don't look a gift horse in the mouth.
Save some baby stuff for us.
Nancy's 6 months behind Terry. There'll be more than enough time.
Yeah, you're next.
Hey, it's a family reunion, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, all of us.
And all of her.
Hey, little buddy. Do I know you? Tracy!
Of peace, King of kings, hallelujah, I am free.